one of the reasons he's such a great writer and such a great contributor to our television show is because his views are so different from that of mine and most of the other writers in the room, especially Jesse Klein, who's the head writer of the show. We butt heads, we get in fights because he infuriates us. And the room is, it's an interesting writer's room because it's always been very diverse with the views in there. We don't want it to just be one-sided. We don't want it to, Jesse and I have such similar sensibilities that it's good to, it feels very positive to have someone in there saying, well, this is from the male perspective. And not that Kurt is but he is the most male, you know, like the most out there perspective possible. Kurt's my friend, I love him. I'm not on Facebook, so I don't read his crazy rants. Like, he just, he gets something from going after people, making them mad. That is not representative of me at all. You know, I've asked him, just, can you just stop? Because it comes back to me. People, because he writes for the show, it's a bigger story because of our connection. And so whatever tangent he's gone off on, I have not agreed with, and it's been really upsetting to me seeing someone that I care about hurt themselves like this. And so, you know, right now there's no plans for the TV show to come back in any time in the near future. So nobody's on my staff. There are no writers. I think people, you know, they want his head. They want to burn him at the stake. Yeah. And
you want?
I want them to not attach me to what he's writing. And I would love to refocus the energy and the attention on the real problem, which is, I feel, people understanding is about rape.
Yes.
And what's consensual and what's not. And because they really, the way that he's been gone after, because he baits people. He's the problem, no question. But the focus is on him rather than on what the real main problem is.
You mean a smart understanding of what rape has become and what we're now understanding about it.
Yeah.
I mean, you look at what's happening on campuses and you look at a whole range of places.
Right.
Where
yeah.
people in 2016 are stepping forward who did not step forward before.
Yeah, I think it's great that people are stepping forward, and if it's not done in a way that Kurt feels is right, it's, you know, that's really upsetting to hear. It's like we all need to be empowering each other, but to focus your energy on online trolling, if I did that, I wouldn't get anything done. Let's focus on actually getting the problem done. And I was sexually assaulted. I encourage women to come out, and I want men to hear what happened so that there's no confusion, because there are different, people have different understandings of what sexual assault is, what rape is. So let's all get on the same page so that it happens less.
It is extraordinary when you see somebody come out and make an accusation, and then all of a sudden, you know, especially if it's with somebody well known, all of a sudden you see people who have experienced the same thing.
Yeah.
And step forward to say, me too.
Yeah.
But I was afraid to speak out.
Yeah. I think it's good, it's helpful, and it makes people feel less alone. Mm. And it's such an unfortunate, awful thing with all these gray areas where you don't know, because because of things like this, where there's so much victim shaming. Right. When a woman says they were assaulted, a lot of people's first reaction is to say, no, you weren't. Like, what was the situation?
Yeah. And it's just, what were the circumstances?
Yeah.
How late was it?
They treat it like the Salem witch trials, and it's just, it's really unfair, and it makes women not want to come forward.
Was their heart